Our next guest is a 62 years old male patient, known HCV related liver cirrhosis, complains of abdominal pain of 1 month duration, abdominal ultrasound to liver cirrhosis and mild splenomegaly, triphasic multi-slice CT abdomen show, liver cirrhosis with malignant featuring left hepatic loop, focal lesion, segment 2, 4x4 centimeters, minimally enhancing arterial phase, HCC versus cholangiocarcinoma with multiple abdominal lymphadenopathy. Patient is referred for U.S. assessment.
Who is going to examine him? Professor Giovannini?
Yes, Dr. Giovannini.
Okay.
This was one of the criteria of Barcelona many years ago, but now they change. We come back to the histology to be sure. It could be also sometimes mixed tumor, hepatocholangiocarcinoma. Okay.
Professor Giovannini, you are with you.
Yes, where are you? I am.
Yeah, okay.
It's just to show you the capability of the US to perform liver biopsy. And there is a recent paper was published, I think, in Endoscopy two months ago, on the use of the 19 and 22 gauge needle to perform a biopsy in the left lobe in patients with fibrosis, to evaluate the fibrosis. And the quality of the biopsy was very good. It was possible in all cases to appreciate the portal space to do the diagnosis. And also the main advantage is you can use in patients with blood coagulation disorder, low liver platelets, and ascites, which is sometimes dangerous to do by peritoneal bleeding.
Great.
Yeah. And I know that Cook company is working on a special needle for liver biopsy. We don't know where this will be available, but this is the future. And also, Cook is working as a new system for the evaluation of the pressure in the portal vein, and using an anti-engaged needle with a special accessory to give us very quickly the pressure without the need to do non-jugular, which is sometimes not very available, and also for the patient because the patient with also again if you come back with patient with cirrhosis, sometimes you have a blood disorder and it's not easy to perform the transfusion. Ah yes.
Professor Giovannini.
Yeah. Yes.
Professor Giovannini.
Yes.
Would you think that in the future we'll have tips through the school? Tips from the US?
What? Through the scope? You can repeat the question to Rally.
Through the scope? I don't understand what can through the scope?
Now we are looking at the liver by the US. Would you think that in the future we can apply tips through the US?
Tips through the US. We can apply in the future tips?
Mm-hmm. Tips. Alors, I know that there is a lot of work on animal, but in animal is possible. But the main problem of the tips, if you use the US, is that you face patient with portal hypertension. And if you want to assess the left lobe, you should pass through the gastric wall. And if you have locked vessels, it will be probably difficult. And ascites also is a contraindication for EUS. No, get the procedure because you have a risk of I'm not sure that this will be possible, but I know that some team works on it, and in animals it's possible. In animals it's possible. This was done and published. Okay, I will start the examination for this gentleman. Okay, we are into the esophagus.
Can I have the US, please?
I pass so slowly the...
Only the US.
Sorry? No, I use the endoscopy view to pass. No. Because if you have a hyperemia or something like this, you have a risk of perforation.
Now the large the US, please. Top of the US.
Okay, now we move for the US image. Here you see the pancreas. This is the pancreas, the body, which has an aspect of chronic pancreatitis. Now I turn the scope to see the liver. I should aspirate the air because the air is the enemy of the US. I'm sorry, but I'm not in a good position here. Okay, this is much better. Okay, here we are. Yeah, this is the spleen, which is huge. And if I turn the scope, here you have some lymph nodes. And this is the spleen again. The liver is here. Okay, it's a little bit atrophic. And here you have the liver. You have nodes and the mass. Is I need to do something to reduce the size and to see deeper. It's here. We saw if I do like this. Yeah. Okay, yeah. You see the lesion here. It's close to the. Okay. Yeah. Nicolette Lobe. Yes. Here. I don't know if it's lymph node or if it's expansion, yes, but it's the same. I come back. This is the inferior vena cava. Yeah, there is a thrombosis. Yeah, and the lesion is here. Okay. And the lesion is here. Yeah, there is probably thrombosis of the portal vein, of the bifurcation, of the... this is a big... Could be a big node, this. Could be a big node, and this is the primary lesion, yes. Yes. It's enough. No. This is the more simple, I think. And for this reason that we will do the biopsy of this big node here. I will use a large needle. If you have a 19 gauge, we'll be as you want.
What's inside the lymph node? Is it calcification or what?
Yes, could be calcification. Yes. I don't know. You see, on elastography is very hard.
It's hard.
Yeah.
Dr. Ali, the point here this is not the pedifocal mass. This is a plain and dropping lymph node. And we have the pedifocal mass.
The mass is here. The mass is here.
Can you specify the vessels around this node?
The mass is here.
Yes. Yes, this is the mass, Dr. Ali.
Okay.
Ali.
Yeah, here.
This is the large hepatic mass.
Okay.
And this, I think,
is thrombosis of the
thrombosis of the portal vein.
Yes. The portal vein.
Yes. I will mark the skin and
there is no flex.
know what they think it is in the liver.
Very difficult to know. No, no. Yes, it's elongated. Yes, this is a reference here, you see. And you, all this, yes. It's not a. Okay, we go to the biopsy here. Always when you have multiple targets, always to use to select the easier. It's not a competition to do the biopsy on the most difficult area just to prove that you can do. You should think that you have a patient, and the first goal is to have no complication. Many patients with advanced cancer like this, it's mandatory not to have any complication. Okay, to perform the biopsy, the first step is to put the lesion in the middle of the image, like this. Okay, now you adjust the length of the sheet, 5 millimeter, and after with the elevator you can move, and you can see that you can move. If you want, you can put the Doppler, be sure, and you remove a little bit the stylet, like this, and you go inside the lesion, like this. Okay, now let's go for technique or remove it? You want, you can do slow pull if you want. Okay, and you can do also the fanning. Okay, stop. Now with the fanning you can change the position. You put the needle just at the upper part of the lesion. You turn the big wheel, and you have another incidence inside the lesion. Okay, go. No, I think the. Yes, you can go. I think if you see the result of the literature, if you use slow pull, wet, suction, no stylet, there is no difference. The only thing that you can. What was proved in randomized study, it's the fanning technique. Fanning technique was, it's the paper from Varadajulu. They show that this improved the accuracy. And the second is the aspiration with 10 milliliters syringe. This is the recommendation of the IGE society. Not the IG, the ESG, the European Society. This is the two things. The other, you do what you want in collaboration with your pathologist. Huh? If your pathologist prefer wet, you use wet. If he prefer with the stylet, you prefer with the stylet. It depends that. How do you know that it's vascular? You see this, you suspect this is a hepatocellular carcinoma, but it's not vascular. You should discuss with your pathologist. It's very important, and you decide together. You send a specimen with slow pull, with no aspiration, with aspiration, with a different technique, and the pathologist will choose what is better. For us, we prefer that we do with the aspiration. In other team, they prefer with a wet technique. It depends that, I think all the techniques are equivalent. Do you have a core or not?
Oh, there is a
hole. I think it's enough, no? Would be probably an hepatocholangiocarcinoma, because cholangiocarcinoma is common to have nodes.
I agree with you.
It's a good comment. Very good comment. You have enough? Okay.
I think there is here a
book. There's a corn here. Oh, yes, yes. This is a nice corn. Okay. And if there, I agree with you that this is, it's not so bloody, is that this, you see the corn that is fibrous. This is probably more often for the diagnostic of cholangiocarcinoma. Because the hepatocholangiocarcinoma, I agree with you, is not, there is a, it's a, one of the hypervascular lesions. This is the node. Or it's a fibrolamellar, pulver fibrolamellar. But again, the node is not usual. We will see with the. Okay.
Here, the point is to discuss these patients is a good example of difficult to be biopsied by CT or CR. This will take the easy.
Yeah.
Can you give us what is the most nice segments to be sampled by this
study? Is the segment 2 and 3, a part of the segment 4. Not all the segment 4, but the part. In the segment 1, sometimes it's through the duodenal wall. After you can try, and sometimes it's, but it's not, the position is difficult. And but now with the new scope of Pentax, with there are a lot of, the bending is much better. You can have some very easy position. But again, it's not easy to. Sometimes you see very well the lesion, and when you insert the needle, the scope is a little bit more rigid, and you lose your position because you insert the needle, yeah. And you cannot do the biopsy. This is something. But when you have now today, if the patient has a multiple liver lesion, and if there is a lesion in the left lobe, we move for the US biopsy and not for the peritoneus, because we can do this very in ambulatory patient. No risk of bleeding. This is very important. Patient is discharged. Don't stay during 6 hours with the ice, because this is the rule in France. And also we have a look on papillaries, and sometimes you find that the primary lesion. I know. It has to be. He has a big nodes. No. Radio frequency is a local treatment. No. He has too much lymph node, too big, and he has a thrombosis. No. For liver mets, the it's mainly now the surgeon that do this, or the radiologist. We stop for the liver mets. We do perioperatively. If not, we continue for HCC, for isolated metastasis of neuroendocrine tumor. But for the colon, we do more often radiofrequency in the lung for the lung metastasis. This is more often than for the liver. No. This is on CT. This could be in the left lung. We have published a case like this many years ago, and now I have performed two or three patients with a very small HCC in the left lung, in which was not possible to target by the radiologist, because it was very close to the left.
Sura.
We do
by.
We do
by.
We
do
by. No radio frequency. With the same system that we
demonstrated.
The same. Ahmad, twice. Good experience. It's possible. So far, the same. Masha'Allah. Twice. Twice. Good. The
there is also not in the mediastinum, you see here?
Yeah. And I think it's, despite it is a small, but I think...
Oh, this is malignant, 100%. It's blue, it's nice blue. It's blue like my eyes. No, this is not good. For me, it's more empirical.
This is the Ferrari, the Tumula?
This is 100%.
Really, can do the stimulation very hard.
But you know you should put the at the same level, yes. one ear, and the same size.
Yes. the same level. Yes.
If not, there is no. Oh, no. This is okay. This is good.
Strain ratio is 9.1 more than 3. Mm. So it is very suspicious, despite small, but very suspicious of being connected.
Yes,
But the patient is cirrhotic. So the first possibility of malignancy in a cirrhotic patient is hepatocellular carcinoma.
Okay, I remove the scope.
These patients with surprising enough was
the result is positive.
Yes, yes.
Ah, okay. Hepatocellular carcinoma.
And this
is an hepatocellular carcinoma with lymph node.
This patient was referred for interventional radiology and and of course it is now out of any...
No, you should receive Nexalar treatment because it's still that is stage E or B in the cirrhosis because there is no ascites. I don't know the performing time and but he has a positive lymph node. Is outside of the liver, and it is a M1, it's a metastatic disease. And the metastatic should receive all the Nexavar treatment.
What is your experience with Nexavar? I think it is inefficient as well. What is your experience?
Very bad. it's very expensive. For a lot of side effects.
Dr. Hussein?
Aywa?
At the beginning of the case, Dr. Mubin said that the patient looks like a chronic pancreatitis.
Yes.
Do you apply different criteria at a classic or just evaluate?
We need to be very careful for the diagnostic of chronic pancreatitis with the US.
Yeah.
We have some change of the parenchyma. The pancreatic parenchyma can change for many things, for the age, for the even the patient has an, like this patient, yes, sclerosis, this can change the, but we cannot speak about the real chronic pancreatitis. It's some fibrous change of the gland, but the patient has no clinical sign of chronic pancreatitis.
Many
patients I saw, they say, oh, I have a chronic pancreatitis because I did an US because I have a little pain. The pain was an irritable colon, neuropathy.
But from the practical point of view, during your daily work, you apply it in every patient you suspect, or you just evaluate the patient generally, it's not like a chronic pancreatitis or not?
No, for me, chronic pancreatitis is. You need to have some clinical sign. You need to have the main sign is the lobular aspect, the hyperechoic foci, and the calcification. And if you don't have very well visible pancreatic duct with a thick hyperechoic wall, after all the aspect, a little bit heterogeneous of the parenchyma. It's not enough to complete to a chronic pancreatitis, and it's very. You need to be very careful on the diagnostic, and the main diagnostic is done by the MRCP with the secretin test, and this is the
yeah. So the
you cannot say only by the image of US. You should combine the US and the CT and the clinical.
from your evaluation, the rescue criteria is not a definitive.
No.
Yeah.
No. You have too much patient as the diagnostic of chronic pancreatitis. We only on the US image, but it was not.
So it is good. We can say that it is good positive. It is not a good negative.
Yes.
Yeah. And that's what we face in a real practice. That the patient usually not fulfill the criteria, but if the patient clinically go with chronic pancreatitis.
If the patient has no sign, why to do an exploration of the pancreas? If the patient came with pancreatic pain, IV-based, of course I will do the US and I will see if the there is some sign or not. But I need not only of the US image, I need also of the MRCP image and with the secretin test to see if there is a dilation of the main duct after injection of secretin or not. And with all this finding, you can conclude to early chronic pancreatitis. If the patient is asymptomatic, and mainly some patients are asymptomatic or the pain is not related with the pancreas, it's mainly irritable bowel disease, and the patient came with an US, they showed that I have a chronic pancreatitis. No, it's not a chronic pancreatitis, it's some change. To be sure, you need to have a histology, you know, of the pancreas. Yeah.
Thank you so much, Prof. Mark. And now we will check with Professor to another case. Or?